Right. Good morning, everyone. Still working on the scene carving algorithm. It's part of our code and game solving spree. And what I did after yesterday morning's session, I just went back and deleted pretty much everything. I've been struggling with TDD in the past few days, trying to figure out how to use TDD when working on a complex algorithm. And I've had people give me a few pointers, and that really helped. And one of the problems I had was I was starting with test cases that were too big. For instance, this one right there, it's a 30 by 8 pixels image size. And when you're looking at that, you're thinking, well, I need to find a path in there that has the least energy. How am I gonna do that, right? The only thing you can think of is implementing the entire algorithm. Yeah. So that's kind of the problem. So I thought we could start over today and start with really small test cases. For instance, a 1x1 pixel image, and then a 2x1. By one, but with the pixels differently positioned, etc. So I was kind of fooling around with that today, and so let's try that. See what we get. Ignore these tests as we go. So first one. Okay, so I have a. Actually, I'm not even done properly formatting the test, so I have to do that too at the same time. So we've got a 1x1 image pixel, 1x1 pixel image size, yeah. And 123 here is actually our kind of our grayscale value from 0 to 255. Now, we know that our algorithm needs to calculate the, this here, right? Which is not that complicated. You're just basically looking left, looking right, and seeing the difference between the two. And you're doing the same thing, looking up, looking down, and seeing the difference between the two. And then you're adding these, and that's your energy function. So it really isn't that all that complicated, except that if 0 is smaller than x, which is not the case here, or x is smaller than the width, minus 1. Otherwise, left, right borders. Right. So if it's left or right borders, our energy function is actually 0. So there you go. That's our first, it applies here to our first case. Because, it's a border. It's the center, it's the right border, it's the left border, it's the upper border, the bottom border, the top border, the bottom border. It's every possible kind of border because it's a 1x1 image. So it would return 0. And that would be obviously the least important path. Right. I think the puzzle designer might not have taken into account. If our entire borders are valued zero, at zero, then automatically the path of least resistance will be the border. And it's always only going to the borders. That's interesting. And that's obviously not what's happening here, so I guess vertical path is a sequence of pixel 0, 0, 0 such that x I plus 1. Okay, right, n minus x I plus 1 minus x I is smaller or equal to 1. Okay. So in other words, the path contains exactly the perfect line of consecutive pixels are vertically or diagonally neighbors. And it can't include the orders, or can it? That's interesting. And it makes a big difference on how we deal with this. Let's see if there's any that in the form. Working on my laptop today because I'm on vacation. And I have the one screen, so I'm gonna use my tablet. Look at that, too long to respond. That's interesting. Okay, well. I'm reading this sequence of pixels, so that's x, y, x, y, x. So starting at x 0, 0, x 1, 1, x height minus 1, to height. That x I plus 1 minus x I one pixel per line and consecutive pixels are vertically or diagonally neighbors. The energy of a path is the sum of the energies of its stencils. Yeah, that's... interesting. It just seems logical to me that order pixels are... they should be taken into account, because well, they would always be right otherwise. Always end up removing the leftmost column. So how do we deal with that? Let's see here. So in our one pixel case, obviously it's the only pixel and its energy is zero, so we don't have a choice but to return zero. So let's deal with one thing at a time. Just return zero. Pass our test. Okay, so we didn't even pass that, but how? Oh. Okay, now our next test case. This isn't right here, I'm gonna have to apply that, but it's essentially you got 123 and 182 and 82. So we would need to Excel might be a better okay, so we've got what was it? 123 and 82. 123 and 82. So we need to get the energy for each cell. And how do we do that? Well, got a little energy function here. Can I just paste that in here? What happened? Okay, so basically I need to, well actually we don't need to, we're still dealing with borders here, right? So this would be zero, this would be zero, that, problem solved. So we don't even need to change anything to pass this test. I think it would still return zero, no matter which one. So, yeah, obviously, still passing out. Okay, and if we were to add the middle one. Or if they were switched around, yeah. Doesn't make much sense or difference, should I say. Because they are still all... So, okay, we're just testing the same thing here, basically. Our implementation's never going to change until we get a pixel that's not a border pixel. So, let's skip ahead to that. Like this, we're sure not to miss anything. Even if it seems pretty obvious to me that nothing's gonna change until we get to a 3x3 grid. Oh. Give us zero because we're still dealing with all borders. If I understood the problem correctly. Okay. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we get to 3x3. Let's make our next line. Let's see, 251, 78, 32. How's that? And gotta be careful with those ticks. Don't add new lines where there shouldn't be new lines. Okay. All right, now let's think about this. The energy function is gonna be zero. The energy score is gonna be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. But here it will be something. So let's calculate that. It shouldn't be too hard to do. Let's put that in here. So 123. This control thing. Okay. Go away. Why don't you go away? 82, 73, 72, 75, 36, 127, 251, 78, 32. Okay. Don't need you anymore. We need to do this here. So this would be, let's put it here. This equals, so x plus one. Right, x plus one. Minus x minus 1. Oh no, it doesn't work like that, does it? Like programming, but it's... So I gotta do... x plus 1 is this, right? So that's our energy function. Minus. No, doing this all wrong. Okay, it's just that. Yikes. Yeah, that's better. There we go, that's the difference between the two. 52, and we do the same thing here, where we'll just get it's y plus 1, so this one here minus this one here. There we go. And now finally, here we're simply getting, we're adding the two, the absolute value of the two, so I think it's abs. So now we need to figure out the total value of the scene. The total value of the scene that we're going to be removing. Well, it needs to include this, and we're actually not supposed to remove the borders. That's what I understand. Although, yeah, that's a really weird way to handle this. I really wish I could access this form. Okay, well, for now, we're going to understand this, that we're not supposed to remove these here. never removing the leftmost pixels and the rightmost pixels. So the only thing we can possibly do here is remove the center line. And we are, well, the value would be 0 here. Wait a second. If 0 is more than 1, 0. Otherwise, top bottom borders. Why would the bottom borders be worth 0? If we're removing things vertically. Well, just because you can't really. I understand, you can't really assign an energy. So it would be 0, okay. So here's the deal, this is worth 0. And then this would be worth 0, I'm getting 0 as well. This would be worth 0. It would be worth zero. This would also be worth 0 because the lowest is 0 here. 0. Like this is worth 56. But this is worth 0. This is worth 0. So when we get to this, to these here, well, which one? Which adjacent, you know, top cell? As we go down in our algorithm, has the least. Well, it's this one here, so this would be worth 0. Oh, this is weird, because it seems to me that every single column, in the first two columns will always have a cumulative score of 0 because they'll always pull from the left column, which is always worth 0. Huh. Okay, well let's go with that for now. Might be doing all of that for nothing if I didn't understand this correctly. Ah, there you go, okay. If all the border cells had 0 energy, the lowest path would always be the first column with 0 energy. So I guess you had to explicitly exclude these cells in your computation. Yes. I just ignored all 4 borders. By the way, this puzzle is so nice. Very interesting algorithm, love it. If all the border cells had 0 energy, well, that's telling us no. I just ignored all 4 borders, okay. I too have to thank you for this puzzle. Okay. So just ignore the 4 borders. If I ignore the 4 borders, am I left with here? I'm left by a 1 pixel. I'm left with a 1 pixel by 1 pixel. So should I first parse the entire thing, remove the borders, and treat that as a boy. think about this here. If I did that here, this is worth zero. This year, so the value would be 36. Because I get to this, so I start here and say, well, do here, I have to put borders, but I have borders, so forget about it. Same with this here, now I get the both of this. So it's 0, 36. My path would be, this, or that. I guess right on top. So I'm supposed to take the borders. Then here, do the same thing. They'd all be the same thing. So in the end, I would remove what? Whichever one I'd remove, it would still be 36. So let's keep going. Go with 36. So how do I get that? Well, the easiest thing so far would be to simply go. Okay, I need to get my this dot image file dot split on each line. Then, what am I interested here? Interested in 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm only interested in things starting at 4. Hey man, Lenikiz, thanks for the follow. Lenikiz. Okay, so I'm only interested in what's after line 4, so, well, including line 4, so let's just split our resulting array. Right, split, I mean slice. Right, or slice, I think, returns the. The beginning is specific. Returns a section of an array. Yeah, that's cool. So let's get it from row 4. Row 4. And we'll call this our pixels. Then once we have that, if the easiest way to get this one is to go if okay. So if pixels wait, that's not quite right. What do I have here? I need a 2D array. So I need to take my pixels and then map each row instead of getting so take our row and we want our row to become an array for each space between the characters and we'll have a 2D array of strings. There we go. Okay. So now if pixels Pixels.length is smaller than pixels. Actually, we know that anything below 3x3 is just going to have to return to 0. So I guess I can do it that way. Pixels stop. Smaller. That's not the case, then we need to do something. For our test case right now, all we need to do is return 36. Return 36. We'll be in business, I believe. Let's see if we pass our tests. Expected 0, received 36, or height 2 with 3. Okay, so that seems right. Our first test case, second one, we have the two. Okay, so we've got a case where it's just at 123. Correct. In a case where it's 123 and 82. Correct. And 123, 82, 232, 82 rows. Okay. So we're splitting it properly. So the problem is then. Dealing with orders. Alright, let's add a test case. And let's see. So now we're just hard coded. Here. We need to change that. Oh, it's not 36. Change up. Our numbers here to actually force us to do some calculations. Still not quite clear on how we deal with the borders, but figure it out. Now I get 138. 138. Let's run this. So that didn't pass. Instead, because it's hard-coded. So now we actually need to implement some kind of algorithm to calculate this. What are we doing to get to that? Well, we're just taking the center one, so 1, 1, position 1, 1, and we're looking to the left, looking to the right. So let's do that. Simply go this cost. We need the, what is that, like basically the x, the x, what is that called, the partial, forget the name. Delegate calculus is, let's look it up to name our stuff properly. So what we're doing here is basically getting a gradient.
So why?
Gradient is derivative. That's right. So the x derivative is what we're basically getting. Partial derivative, but let's just call it x derivative. Or
where there was no cornfield, no memory.
Maybe just keep it simple and call it x gradient. Is equal to
come with me.
Pixels. So we're looking at pixel 0. No, that's not true. So 1, 0. Right. First row. Yep. And then we're... No, it's actually the opposite. We're looking at pixel 0, 2. M. Minus, yeah, okay, pixel, like this, like that, the left hand side, yeah, okay, oh, because they are all strings, so let's change that here, let's get, so we're mapping to row.split, us an array that we want to pass in a number function. That should, yeah, there we go. Might have to refactor that later on. This is getting a little hard to understand. Okay. So that's our, basically our right, our pixel to the right of the one we're evaluating. And now we're gonna get our pixel to the left. Okay. And we're gonna get our Y gradient. So pixels. So we're doing y is 0 and also zero pixels. Y is 2. Now we just do, I think it's math.abs. Alright, we're good. So that, you see, that forced us to kind of implement our function here, but we're hard coding the fact that we only need to evaluate the center one here because all the other ones are worth 0. So let's add the test case. The next logical step, it would be to add a column, make it wider. So height 3, width 4. So let's add 67. 42. And 123. 6. There you go. Okay, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. 67, 42, 126. Well, 42, 126. to 26. Now this gets more interesting. So in this case here, we're going to have to choose between these two. How do we choose between the two? First we need to evaluate. Well, we could probably still just evaluate the two of them, because this one won't pull from this one, this one won't pull from this one. This is zero, there's nothing to look at. Same here. This one could pull from this. But since we're not supposed to move the leftmost pixels anyways, is bigger than zero. Yeah. So these are all zeros. That's their energy function. Then as we go down, there's two ways to deal with this. This is what's confusing. So, as part of the algorithm, first we just assign our energy score to each one, and that's fine. I mean, the border ones just end up being zero. That's easy to do. But afterwards, the idea is that you find the path with the least cumulative score, the smallest cumulative score. And basically like a kind of a graph. What you do is you start in the second row. That's what the algorithm is. You start in the second row. Look at the top three above you. The one right on top in diagonal. And take the least score from this. Add it to your score. And then you keep going. But if we're doing that with the left row, then here our score is zero. We're looking at zero. So this is where it starts. We'd be looking at these two. Well, we'd get zero. Now here we would get zero and something. But we're looking for the smallest one, so it would always be zero, 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 zero. But the thing is that would also be the case for our friend on the second column. If if I pull from this, then it's always going to be 0. Then I'm here, then I'm always going to have access to 0. Here, I'm always going to have access to 0. So in the end, if I do it that way, the second row will also... well, it won't have 0, I guess. It'll have its own score. If I'm starting here, it's got a score of whatever it is. Yeah, calculated 50-something. Plus 0. Okay, fine. So we're at 50-something. Then we go down here, it's got its own score. Plus 0. So now, yeah, we always end up moving to the... That doesn't make sense. It should take it into consideration that algorithm at all. And as you go down to the bottom, I think that's how we'll implement it. So, okay, that being said, we've got our score here of H4 minus 1. Got our score of 138. There, and we'll have a score of, just basically move this here, and there, here, there, score of 206. So I end up with 138 here, and I end up with 138 here too, because I do have access to this guy here. Is it 138? Is that what we had hard coded yet? So obviously we end up with 138 still. Want that, let's change things a little bit, because then I could just cheat, not change anything, I wouldn't be testing much. So let's make this here a pretty big number too, so 201. Let's change that to 201. Get our friends back where we wanted them. Just to make sure. That's okay. So our answer should be 206. Will be our path of least resistance, if you will. Now we need to change how we're dealing with this here. And we're going to do that by could just do this twice, basically. Gradient magnitude 1. Not a number. Which one? By 3 with 3. Return, not a number. Expected 56. I'm trying to access properties that might not be there. So it's starting to look like I don't have a choice but to actually the algorithm, start to implement the algorithm properly. Okay. How would I do that? Well, the first logical thing we need to do entire array, so if that's what we need to do, I'm going to make a for each. For each row. For each row of our pixels array, we also want to get the x. No, row is going to be y. And then we need to go to each row. And we're going to be, let's see, are we going to be making a new array, or should we just change that? I prefer to make a new array. If we run into memory problems, if it was a really big file, I don't think so. I think we're fine. So let's do a pixels.map. So that's going to return a new array. That's our top level array. Okay, and what are we doing? This is where we need to do a little energy function thing here. Try to access. Try to access it. Probably is there. It's going to return on the find or see. If I do this, what? We'll get it. Let's do array. And then that's y guy stays the same. Actually, I guess I could just use the rope. Right, that would be simpler if I just do a rope. Like that, because I know evaluating the surrounding of the pixel. Now the problem I'm gonna have is when I'll run into edge cases, really edge cases, like the edges of the picture. I need to return zero. So, would maybe a try-catch be the solution here? Because if I'm trying to, let's see, if I'm trying to access a property that is not there, what is that going to do? It's going to return undefined, it's not going to throw an error. But if I try to access a property on undefined, then that's gonna throw an error, I think. Let's test my theory. Right. Too much stuff going on here. Come on. browser. So let's just make a foo array. One and two. It's got to be a. Let's make it a. Now, if we try to get foo at minus one, what are we going to get? Undefined. But if we try to get foo minus one, and then zero, there we go. We do get an exception. So if we're trying to get... but that wouldn't work, though. It would work just in some cases, because here's an example. Let's say that our y is in the range, right? But that our x isn't. We're just getting undefined. We're not getting an exception. So. What happens if we try to do undefined, or let's say 13 minus undefined? We get not a number. Okay, so maybe we can work with that. Wrap this in try. Rolls up in our face. So this will take care of the case where the y is out of bounds. But what if our y is not out of bounds, but our x is? Then gradient is going to become not a number. So let's make an if statement here. If x gradient or y gradient equals an n, then return 0. Otherwise, return the thing we're looking for. Now, I don't know, that seems like a really, what's my other option? Making another if statement to first check we'd only look to that problem with the y gradient, I guess. Because if we get here, we're using a row, we know that we're okay. Then we're taking care of the n. So maybe news. Unless we add this check here to we could do that. Like a whole bunch of them. Yeah, okay, let's do that. Actually, here's what I'm gonna do. I'll refactor later. So I've got a green. Check that row. Also, that out of bounds. And that row. Is also not out of bounds. Turning on the fine, and I can just get rid of this. Say if this is all good, then not all of it, just this here. Okay, now this will give us a shiny new array of, what are we going to call this? Gradient magnitude. Let's just call it pixels with scores. Pixels with scores. Yep. Or with energy, maybe. With energy. Okay. Okay. So now that we've got this, we simply, if we're looking at our case here, we need to I could go back to just taking whichever one has the otherwise, return pixels with energy at 1, 2. Let's run this. I would have been surprised if it was green. We've got 2 failing test cases. We are returning a number. That is our problem here. Well, that's part of the problem. We're supposed to get 138. We're getting a 0 as a number. Let's see what happens if I do that. Yep. So. Fight three with three. Why there was a problem here? That's interesting. What we're saying is if it's smaller than 3, return 0. Which it isn't. Alright, so then we're going into this here. And that being the entire thing. Curious to see, console log hour pixel with energy array, see what we get. Getting 56, yeah, 138, 257, 206, and these are working, right? We've got test cases for these, 206, yeah, so we're failing at this one. we're expecting to get this value here. We're getting zero. So why would that be? Because we screwed something up. That's just why. Okay. Ah. Okay, we're probably getting to this check here. And we're trying to compare pixel at 1-1. With a pixel that has 0, and it's not smaller. So we're, yeah, okay. Easy fix, easy fix. If pixels dot link. Let's see, is equal to 3. And pixels 0 dot length is also equal to 3. In that very special case, all you need to do is return. No, I can't have that here because I need. That right here. So just return pixels with energy 1-1. Should probably take care of it. Let's do this. Yay, we have passed. Okay, getting somewhere. Should we refactor? Should we refactor our code? Well, there's this here that bugs me. So I could just extract that to somewhere. Extract to method in class PM. Image, extract to function in module scope, extract to constant in closing scope. What would that give us? Yeah, I think that's the one I prefer. I could have it as a private method on the class. Yeah, I could do that. Let's see what that would look like. Okay. This new method, and we're gonna call this, if this is Not out of bounds. Well, let's just call it is inbound. Inbound. Within bounds? Yeah, I like this better. Is within within bounds. If this is within bounds, that's the thing that we need to pass in these parameters. Right? The y, the rho, the x. Yeah, that's fine. That is fine. Great. So now let's stretch. Let's do that first. Okay. Just move on to our next test case. Let's do that. Well, we could add one more width until it gets really annoying and so this isn't hard-coded anymore, so yay for us, but we're still hard-coding this. That's what we want to get rid of. Let's do that. See, to add 42 and 43, add 174, and this here is going to be 132, 43, 174, 132. If we want this test to be meaningful, it should return something different, and it should be lower. Than the 257 we were getting here. How are we getting to 257 here? Thank you. problem. So we want these to be okay. This will return. That's fine. But here we still want numbers. Here we still want numbers because we need to do stuff with them. Turned into strings here. Let's remove this and remove that. We'll just call this const output. Okay, so yeah, it's failing. Which case is failing here? 3 with 5, 3 with 4, 3 with 3. Well, this shouldn't fail. Oh, but I got rid of my if. Oh. Of course. That would take into account our borders. We don't want to take our borders into account. In finding this. So let's get our... We need our current index. We do. So let's get our X. And then... If... X is equal to 0. X is equal to 0. Now we still need to take care of this test case here. The case where we've got... That will take care of it. Alright, got about 8 minutes left here. So I don't think I'll have time to implement a new test and go through a whole red-green cycle, but I can refactor now, can I? Oops, what did I do? I broke something. What could we refactor here? Our remove scene function is getting pretty big. It's doing a lot of things, but...
pixels value to a array of
So I think that's going to be it for today. Keep going tomorrow. I'm working on this by myself to be a little bit disheartening.